Yes, a very good morning to one and all. And today we will be starting. First of all, am I audible? Someone can please write in the chat box so I'll come to know. I'm audible to you all. Yes, okay, Arya. Thank you. Let me just check. The volume is clear. One moment, just take that. Yes. Okay, so next topic, that is coordinate geometry, and we'll just immediately start because I have already talked a lot much in the last lecture about it. So coordinate geometry, how I'll be doing today, we will be revising some concept from your 9th standard, and along with that, what you are having or what you have studied in this year. So this year, you have studied distance formula, then you have studied section formula for internal division, and then midpoint formula. So midpoint formula is actually a extension of your, it is your section formula only. And the next one, that is last one, it will be centroid formula. So these are the four formulas, but along with that, some basic concepts of 9th standard. So I'll just start with a few concepts of 9th standard, then we will go to the 10th standard. All these four formulas we will discuss. And of course, at the end, MCQs, which can be asked. So certain MCQs we will be discussing. I have a list of certain, so we will discuss. So let us start with, first of all, a very basic concept, that is line. So what is line? So line, if I say L, it is made up of infinite points. It is made up of infinite points. And now, student, this each point on a line is associated with a number. And that number is called as coordinate of that point. For example, if I write, suppose here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, some numbers I write. Okay. Certain numbers I have selected. Then I have selected over here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. So these are the numbers if I select. So if I ask randomly, okay. If I ask A, so what's the coordinate of A? A simple question it is. So A is associated with 4. So therefore, 4 will be called as coordinate of point A. If suppose I say B is on a number line, if I ask what will be the coordinate of B, it will be minus. So if a number line, so we have understood like, okay, every number which we are talking about, okay, which is associated with that number, we are going to call it as a coordinate of that. Now, same number line, student, the same number line, okay, so if I hold vertically, so what will happen? Earlier, due to this line, the plane was got divided into two parts. The moment I draw one more number line, what happens to the whole plane? It gets divided into four quadrants. It gets divided into four quadrants. So let's see. One moment. Yeah, just let me clear this. So, yeah. So as I have said, when I have drawn a horizontal line, the whole plane was got divided into two parts. And the moment I have drawn a vertical line, so actually this horizontal line and this vertical line, so they are lines. But when I draw this vertical line, this whole plane has got divided into four parts. Each part is called as a quadrant. And anticlockwise, if I number them, so first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, and fourth quadrant. So these are the four quadrants in which the whole plane gets divided. Now, this horizontal, that is what we are having, horizontal line, we call it as the x-axis. And how we name it? X, O, X dash, and the vertical which I have drawn, that is called as y-axis, so Y, O, Y dash. OX is a positive direction of x-axis. OX is a positive direction of x-axis. So here it will be 1, 2, 3, suppose I say 4. So OX will be positive direction of x-axis, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. This is a negative direction of x-axis. Then OY. OY will be positive direction of y-axis. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And let's have 5 here. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and minus 3. So OY dash is called as a negative direction of x-axis. So student, when number was on a line, it was very easy. On a line, like we have said, A, what is A, a coordinate of that a particular point? So number associated with that. But if the point is in the plane somewhere, so for example, now I erase this. If I want to find, so let us take a point over here and we will call this point as A. And if I want to know coordinates of A, so you know how it is, easy method it is. What you'll be drawing, doing? You will be drawing a perpendicular. You will be drawing a perpendicular on x-axis. And from A, you will be drawing perpendicular on y-axis. The moment you draw a perpendicular from A-axis to on x-axis, that point which we get or where it intersects that perpendicular drawn, that point will be called as x coordinate of given point. That will be 2. And from A, we have drawn a perpendicular on y-axis. Where that perpendicular is meeting y-axis, that point. So you can see that 3. So 3 will be called as y coordinate. So student, remember, we always write x coordinate first and y coordinate second. We write x coordinate first and y coordinate second. Now this is what very simple way I have told you, what is x coordinate and y coordinate. But what's the meaning of x coordinate of a point? So x coordinate means the distance of that point from y axis. Actually it's a definition or it's meaning. Its meaning is, what is x coordinate? So x coordinate is the distance of that point from y axis. So you can see that why we have got 2. So you can see the distance of that point, so A, from y axis is actually 1, 2. So you can see that 2 units, and therefore its coordinate is distance. So what is, what then you say, so what about y coordinate? So y coordinate is the distance of that point from x axis, exactly opposite. Y coordinate is a distance from x axis, and x coordinate is a distance from y axis. So from what will be the x coordinate, we have said from y axis distance was 2 unit, and y coordinate will be the distance of that point from x axis. So see the distance, 1 unit, 2 units, and 3 units. That's why y coordinate is three. This is the basic definition. Okay, so now student, in the first quadrant, you can see the x coordinate is a positive 2 plus 2. And 3 is also plus 2. And very simple. Why? Because it is 4x is a positive direction. So x and y both are positive. So therefore, we can say in first quadrant, plus plus. That is, both have in first quadrant, you will have both that first quadrant, both the coordinates will have plus sign. Now let us move to the second quadrant. Can you tell me in second quadrant what will be the signs of x coordinate and y coordinate, or what will be x coordinate and y coordinate in general? Yes, plus minus. Very good connection. So here, of course, x, you can see here it is minus and y is plus, so it will be minus plus. Then in third quadrant, yeah, this is very simple. You have studied in 9. So here, So x is minus. So that's why I'm showing this. Most of the time we don't follow the concept. So that's why I'm just telling you x coordinate is minus and y coordinate is also minus, negative. And then in fourth quadrant, it will be yes. It will be x coordinate you have to write. So x coordinate will be plus. Okay, x coordinate will be plus, x is plus and y is minus. So by knowing the sign or looking at the sign, for example, if I have a point 5 comma minus 4. So if I want to know where it will be, actually you can plot it, but just looking at the signs, we can decide 5, what's the sign of 5? Yeah, it will be in fourth quadrant. Or plus minus. So the moment I come to know plus minus, I'm sure about it, it will be fourth quadrant. So in this way, yes, in the fourth quadrant, very good. So in this way, this is your basic of what are the like fourth quadrants and what is meant by an x coordinate, what is meant by y coordinate, and very important is that is x coordinate we write always first and y coordinate always we write second. Okay, so this was about coordinate system. Then let's move. Again, I'll just have coordinate system. This is a very small topic actually. So in CET 2 or 3, as I said, questions can be asked. Now let's have again. Now you are well versed with y-axis, then x-axis. So this will be x, x dash, y, y dash. And this is point of intersection where they are meeting, that is point O. Let's have quickly 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. -1, -2, -3, -4. -1, -2, -3, -4. Okay. So now next we will see. I'm just asking you one question and you have to answer me. One second, I'll draw a line. Okay, let us call this as line L. Now student, now this line L which I have drawn, it is parallel to y-axis. Now let's observe what happens and then we will conclude something. So I am having point A over here, point B, point C. Here I will have D, here I will have E, and here I will have F. So what I want one by one, what are the coordinates of, first we will start C. What will be the coordinates of C? Very good. C 2 comma 3, 1 comma 4 someone has said, but that might be, this might be looking in the tab. No, somewhere. It is not, it is 2 comma 4. Yes, correct. 2 comma 4, 2 comma 3. It will be 2 comma 3. B, it will be 2 comma 2, correct. A, 2 comma 1. B, it will be 2 comma minus 1. Okay, one more point I should have added. One more I'm adding here, students, here. I'll be having one more point here, P. I want to, actually this I didn't talk about, this point P. Yeah, D 2 comma. Yeah, Okay, you can give the answer if you want to give. No need to raise the point or raise the hand. It's 2 comma minus 2. And then 2 comma minus 3. Yes. Now P, what will be the coordinates of P? What will be the coordinates of P? 2 comma 0. Very good. 2 comma 0. Student, I want to go to conclude something before that. Now, we have talked about earlier, yes, 2 comma 0, correct. Now, we have talked about points in the quadrant, first, second, third, and fourth. But we didn't talk about if the points are on the axis. So, if a point is on x-axis, then what will be its coordinate? So, remember, student, if the point is on x-axis, remember, its y coordinate is always 0. I'm repeating this again. It's very important property which will be useful to solve the examples of 10th standard also. What I've said that if any point lies on x-axis, then its y coordinate is always 0. Okay, one second. Pratiksha, you have raised your hand and you have a doubt. It's just one second. Can you just type that dear, Pratiksha? Type the doubt so that I can come to know what you want to ask. Because if answer you want to give, you can type. Otherwise, you can just tell me what exactly, because twice you have raised. One moment. Because many chats have. Pratiksha, can you type? Yeah, you have given the answer. Okay. No problem. So, yeah, I'll repeat this. So, if any point is lying on x-axis, its y coordinate is 0. Then what about x-axis, x-coordinate? Simple, where it is at 2. So therefore, 2 will be its x-coordinate and y-coordinate is 0. Now, immediately, before I go to this, one more thing I would like to ask. Yeah, if the point is lying on y-axis, for example, P I have taken, suppose I have point Q over here. So can you tell me the coordinates of, it will be 0, 2. Yes, very correct. So remember, student, this is very important. If any point is lying on y-axis, its x-coordinate is 0. And if any point is lying on y-axis, its x-coordinate is 0. And if point is lying on y-axis, its... I think repeatedly I said that only. If any point lie on y-axis, its x-coordinate is 0. And if any point lie on x-axis, its y-coordinate is 0. Okay, so... Now, let us move to this. So, you might ask why you have asked this line to, what are these coordinates you have asked? Yes, there is a reason. What do I say? Line L is parallel to y-axis. Okay, line L is parallel to y-axis. So, if you observe the coordinates of all the points on line L, yes, very good. Answer is given. That is okay by someone. So, if you observe all the points, their coordinates, then immediately you come to know, sir, all the points which are on this line, in that there is some special thing, that is, x is constant. It means every point which is lying on this line L, its x coordinate is same. That is 2. Yes, y coordinate is changing, but x coordinate is same. And therefore, student, if the property said that, yes, very good, Tushar. Therefore, the property states that if a line is parallel to y-axis, then its equation is always x equal to whichever is that constant. So, for example, here, x is equals to 2. So, therefore, x equals to 2. Is this clear? So, student, other way, what's the meaning of? So, suppose when I say equation of line L is x equal to 2, equation of line is x equal to 2. Now, other way I'm talking about. So, if x is equal to 2, immediately what I come to know? That line must be parallel to y-axis. So, looking at that, if I have been given equation of a certain line is x equal to 2. So, the moment I look that it's x equal to 2, I immediately come to that know that the line must be parallel to y-axis. Okay? And vice versa. So, vice versa means what? If I say equation of line is y equal to minus 3. So to which axis this y equal to minus 3 will this line will be parallel? कौन से एक्सिस को पैरेलल होगी y equal to minus 3 line? It will be parallel to x axis. Okay, it will be parallel to x axis. This is what you have to remember. Now its meaning, let us try to understand the meaning of this. So x equal to 2 means what? It means this line is parallel to y axis and all the x coordinate of that point lying on that line will be 2. Wo line pe jo bhi point hai, whichever points are there on that line, uska x coordinate 2 hoga. Y coordinate will change, but x coordinate will remain same. That's the meaning. It's very important. Because MCQ mein us type ke questions hai. Okay, there is a line. For example, there is a line L and which is parallel to y axis. How that MCQ is? A line L is parallel to y axis, and if 2, 3 lies, if that line passes to 2, 3, then there will be certain options given. Which of the following 4 lies on the given line? कौन सा point उनमें से line पे हो सकता है? So what you have to think, if 2, 3 is given, and then you have to see कौन से axis को parallel है? So y axis को parallel है. It means उसका equation क्या होगा? X equal to 2. So it means whichever point is having x coordinate 2, वही point वो line पे होगा. So out of that 4 you can select. We will be taking MCQ. In that I'll explain. But I hope this is at least you have understood here. Haan, aise decide kar sakte. Ki line kaun se line ko? It is parallel to x axis. So y equal to something hoga. So y equal to whatever you have got. If that coordinate is there, whatever the points are given. So that point which is having minus 3 as its y coordinate, 100% that will lie on that given line. If the line is given parallel to x axis. Okay. So this is about lines parallel. So now student, generalize. If I want to generalize this statement, so if line is parallel to x-axis, if line is parallel to x-axis, then its equation is given as y equal to plus or minus a. What does it mean? Y equal to plus or minus a means it will be either y equal to a or y equal to minus b. So you will say, sir, why y equal to a you are saying and y equal to minus a? Simple. If suppose a line is, if line is parallel to x axis. So there are two chances. If it is below x axis, if it is below x axis, then its equation will be y equals to minus a. If it is above x axis, if it is above x-axis, then what will be the equation? If it is above x-axis, then what it will be the equation? Is it going to be y equal to a or y equal to minus a? It will be y equals to plus a. Very good, Tanisha. Okay. So, if a line is parallel to x-axis and if it is below x-axis, it will be y equal to minus a. If it is above x-axis, it will be y equals to a. Same is if a line is parallel to y-axis, then its equation will be given as x equal to plus a or x equal to minus a. Minus a, or we can use other later, we will use b, plus b or minus b. So what does it mean? So if now you are having here example, if a line is to the right hand side, they use that word in MCQ. If a line is to the right hand side, okay, right hand side of the y-axis. So this is right hand side. So if it is to the right hand side, then the equation will be x equal to plus b, that is positive, because here it is positive x-axis. And if it is to the left of y-axis, if that line parallel to y-axis is to the left hand side, then it will be x is equals to minus 2. That can be negative. Okay, so b can be anything, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, anything it can be. So that you have to remember. So this is if lines are parallel to if it is y-axis and how it will be parallel to x-axis. Now student, a very simple question I'm asking. As I have said, that if a line is parallel to y-axis, its equation is x equal to plus or minus a, and if it is parallel to x-axis, it is equals to y equal to plus or minus b, or that way we have discussed. My question is, listen carefully, if a line is parallel to, if not parallel, if a, what will be the equation of x-axis? What will be the equation of x-axis? Can be asked for y equals to 0. Very good, Mohit. Very good. Very good, Tushar. Yes, y equals to 0. Don't simply say 0. Y equals to 0. Of course, MCQ options will be given. So if a line is that equation of x-axis is y equals to 0, and then what will be the equation of y-axis? Of course, that's very simple. Equation of y-axis is x equal to 0. Remember this. For MCQ, they might ask this type of question. One more question I would like to ask. One more question on this. What are the coordinates? What are the coordinates of intersection of x-axis and y-axis? I'm repeating. What are the coordinates of? Array? Very good. Neha, very good. Quickly, she has given that. Sui, correct. Very good. Gargi has given answer correct. So coordinates of the intersection of y-axis and x-axis are 0, 0 here. So it is 0. So don't write only 0. It will be not, don't have to write, but see 0, 0 will be the coordinates of point of intersection of x-axis and y-axis. 0, 0 will be the coordinate. So you may be asked this type of question also. So that's why I've asked. So far, student, whatever I have talked about, that was about your 9th standard, what you have studied in 9th standard. So let's move to now what you have studied in your 10th standard. So in 10th standard, as I have said, distance formula you have studied. Okay, you have studied distance formula. So let us. So distance formula. Yeah, in between, am I audible? Of course, you are giving answer means I am audible. Whatever I am writing, is it visible properly? Yeah, thank you, Ganesha. Thank you, Ganesha. Okay, yes, thank you. Thank you, Gary. Yeah. Distance formula. So now, no student, why we have to check this? Because every time, I always say that whatever is, how good is that singer, it's that is important. But ultimately, the sound system which is that making available that sound is very important. Same way here, you should be that whatever I'm teaching, it should be clear. That's why every time we have to check nowadays on online. Okay, let's move to the distance formula. Before I move to the distance formula, a very simple thing which you have studied. Suppose if you have a line, same thing that what I have explained, 0, 1, 2, let us take a simple one, minus 1, minus 2. Here I have taken. Suppose I have point A and point B on a number line. If I ask you what is distance AB, how you will find? 6. Just check it properly. Distance AB I have asked. It will be 4. Yes, Avishkar, correct. It will be 4. Whosoever has given 6, it might be some confusion or it may not be visible or something. That can be the reason. Otherwise, yeah, I know you can. So its answer is 4. Yes, correct. So what do we do actually if number line is not given? So if the points are on the same number line or same line, then there is a method that what? Greater coordinate minus smaller coordinate. From greater. So 2 is my greater coordinate. minus smaller coordinate. So that will be minus 2. So it will be minus minus plus, so 2 plus 2, that will be 4. Okay, yes, greater coordinate minus smaller coordinate. Very good, Vedika. So this formula we use. But student, if I have to find distance of a point which is in the plane, that is in Cartesian system, and the coordinates are two coordinates, x coordinate and y coordinate. So for example, if I have x dash, y dash, 0 comma 0, and suppose I have a point P which has coordinates x1 comma y1 and another point, let's say Q, of which coordinates are x2 comma y2. Then if I want to find a distance between these two points in the plane, I can't directly say greater coordinate and minus smaller coordinate. I can't use that formula. Yes, the formula is written. Very good. So you all know that. I'll just revise that formula. So if two points having coordinates, P is having x1, y1 and Q is having coordinates x2, y2, then the distance between P, Q can be found by using formula square root of difference of x coordinate, that is x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. Other way we call it as difference of x coordinate plus difference of y coordinates. For our convenience, we say x2 minus x1. The student, you can have x1 minus x2 the whole square also. The reason is, yes, correct. That way also you can write. The reason is very simple. x2 minus x1 or x1 minus x2. So you will say, sir, if it is 4 and x1 is 5, then it will come negative. Yes. Although it comes negative, square of negative number is positive. Remember, distance is always positive. Therefore, you may write is x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square, or you can write x1 minus x2 the whole square plus y1 minus y2 the whole square. It's one and the same. That's why in general we say that difference of x coordinate plus difference of y coordinate. Okay. So this is what our formula if the points are in the plane P and Q. But suppose I have a point R, and if I want to find distance, and if O is my origin, and if I want to find the distance of that point R from origin. So R is coordinate, if I say X comma Y. And if I want to find the distance of that point R from the origin, distance of point R from the origin, then instead of using this formula, of course you can use, you will get the same answer. For example, you will be doing x minus origin is 0. So x minus 0 the whole square, and y2 if I take y minus 0 the whole square. So actually, directly you can use a formula if a point is away from the origin and we want to find the distance between that point O and R, then it can be used as distance OR, that is O to R, is square root of, directly you can say whatever the coordinates of that point, so square, so x square plus y square. No need to, yes, this will be the formula, yes, Ansh. You can directly use this formula as a square root of x square plus y square. So you will say, is this different formula? No, it's not a different. Again, I am repeating, because if you check, student, x2 ke jagah pe agar main x le lunga aur x1 mera origin hai to uska coordinate aa jayega 0, so x minus 0 ho jata hai x square only. So therefore it is a shortcut, what you can say, if a point is away from the origin, then distance between that point and the origin can be found by x square plus y square. For example, if I take coordinates of R as 4 comma minus or 3 comma minus 4. And if I ask you, what will be distance OR? Tell me the answer. Yes, Arya correct. Tanishka correct. Suhani, okay, Suhani correct. Yes, yes, Mohit correct. 5. So I'm telling answer is 5. Correct, 5 is the answer. So straight away, if you try to solve, you will have the square root of 3 square because x is your 3. So 3 square plus minus 4 the whole square. Directly after something and square root of 9 plus 16, that is square root of 25, and that gives you 5. So yes, this type of example, of course, may be asked in your MCQ or that CET what you are having. So this is about distance formula. Again, I'll revise two formulas. First, x2 minus x1 plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. If coordinates are x1 and y1, P is having x1, y1, q is x2, y2. And the distance of any point from origin can be directly found by using formula x square plus y square, where x and y are the coordinates of the point which is away from the origin. Okay. Next, after distance formula, as I have told you, you will be having section formula. So there are two formulas, but you don't have a section formula for external division. You have only section formula for internal division. So what is section formula? Let us try to see. So if you have been given a segment AB, such that A corresponds to x1, comma y1, and B corresponds to x2, comma y2. It is section formula. Of course, for internal division. Now, so if I have a segment AB such that its coordinates are x1, A is corresponding to x1, y1, and B's coordinates are x2, comma y2. If there is a point on AB such that A dash, P dash, B, they are collinear points. So what P is doing? P divides the segment AB in the ratio M is to N. So AP is M part and PB is N part. Then if P's coordinates are X, comma Y, then X and Y can be found by using formula, that is X is equal to MX2 plus NX1 upon M plus N. MX2 plus NX1 upon M plus N. And Y can be found by using formula MY2 plus NY1 upon M plus N. So this formula can be used to find the coordinates of point P, this point which is dividing the given segment AB in the ratio M is to N. Okay, so is any doubt here? I don't think that is simple formula you should have studied. Okay, next extension of this formula is midpoint formula. So it's very easy. Midpoint formula is very easy. It's just an extension I have said, because it is ratio. When we say midpoint, so what is a midpoint? So let's erase this. Midpoint means if there is a segment, again I'll say that here I will name it something else. PQ, P, okay, let us say ED. Every time we are using AB, AB. So ED is a segment such that, and there is a point S on ED such that ES is equal to SD. Then we know that S will be called as the midpoint of ED. What is midpoint first of all? If that point S is dividing segment ED in two congruent parts, that is ES must be equal to SD. So if E's coordinates are x1, y1 and D's coordinates are x2, y2 and if S, that is midpoint of the given line segment, E's coordinates are x, y, then how we can find the midpoint? So let's see. So it will be x1 plus x2, that is sum of the x coordinates divided by 2, and y is equals to y1 plus y2 upon 2. And the reason is very simple. Why this become 2? Because being a midpoint, it is dividing in the ratio 1 is to 1. So our m becomes 1 and our n becomes 1 in the section formula. So 1 plus 1, it will become 2. And multiplied by that, m was multiplied by, that is m is 1. By 1, when we multiply x1, it will become x1 and then x2. That way, these are the, this is the midpoint formula. So we call this as midpoint formula. So it is actually this extension of section formula. So this is our second formula. So rather distance formula, then section formula, then midpoint formula. And now the last one, that is centroid formula. So let's see. I said that this is a very small topic. Hardly few formulas are there. And as some part was reduced, so all those concepts of slopes and all are not there. So that's why actually nothing remains in this. So next is centroid. Centroid formula. Now, centroid formula. For that, first of all, try to understand what is meant by centroid. Can anyone just type, or I can't ask you to unmute? Yeah, can anyone type center on a triangle? It's not center on a triangle. Point where medians meet. Yes, correct. Correct, Arya. Centroid is a intersection of medians. Okay, correct, Avishkar. So it is, yes, point of intersection, Swani, correct. So it is a point of intersection of medians. Now what is the, once again, a median? What is meant by median? That again a question. Median is, what can anyone type if it is possible? What is median? Because as we say, point of intersection of medians. Okay, formula, it is Mohit has written the formula. Good, very good. But what is median? My question was, what is median? Is anyone know? I know that it, orally it would have been immediately given. Typing, that is what something. Vertex to midpoint of opposite side. Correct. In short, very now it is mentioned correctly. Yes, yes. The line which divides the opposite side in two halves. Correct. Okay. So it's absolutely correct. So first of all, so for that, if I take a triangle, not necessarily it's an equilateral triangle, although it looks like that. A, B, C. So these are the three vertices. Let us say A is x1, y1, B, x2, y2, C, x3, y3. If these are the three vertices, then the correctly said line segment joining the midpoint. So if I say P is the midpoint of BC, then line segment joining the vertex and the midpoint of opposite side is called as median. So AP will be median. Here, if I say Q, that is midpoint. So AQ, BQ will be median. And now I am just because manipulating here little so that you can see PQ R. So if R is a midpoint, then this point of intersection of all medians is called as centroid, and centroid is denoted by letter G. Generally, not necessary, generally. So if we assume coordinates of centroid are x, y, then this coordinates of centroid x and y can be found by using formula x is equals to x1 plus x2 plus x3, that is sum of all x coordinates of the all vertices. So x1 plus x2 plus x3 divided by 3. Sum of all x coordinates of v1 vertices, that is 3 vertices divided by 3, will give the x coordinate of the centroid, and y will be, of course it is similar, sum of all y coordinates divided by 3 will give you the y coordinate of the centroid. Okay, so this is your centroid formula. So on this also various way questions can be asked. Now student, most probably as they have said, the CET is based on your 10th standard syllabus, so therefore there are 95% I'll rather say the chances they will be asking examples based on distance formula, midpoint formula, section formula and centroid formula. But perhaps it should not happen that something based on your 9th standard if they ask. So that's why 9th standard part is also we have discussed, and it is useful to solve some of the time example that concepts are useful, and that's why we have discussed that part. Now, so focus you have to be on this. Now, one more thing, this last question on this, and then we'll start MCQs, discussion of MCQ, what I have. As we have said, G is a centroid. This centroid, can anyone tell me in what ratio centroid divides the median? In which ratio? Konsa? Like what will be the ratio in which? Yes, Tanishka. Correct. 2:1. Centroid always divide the medians in the ratio 2:1. So if something tricky can be asked, at that time you should be aware about. For example, if figure is given and they might give you coordinates of A, then they might give the coordinates of P, that is of median, and might ask what is centroid, right? A ke coordinate diye, P ke coordinate diye figure mein, they might ask you the value of centroid. Then you should not get confused. So at that time ratio nahi diya, so you can use section formula, because when we see this figure, we initially think here centroid ka formula use karna chahiye, but these coordinates and these coordinates are not given, sirf A or P ka diya hua hai, suppose I am telling you. Okay, and this centroid's coordinates are asked. So if you know A's coordinate, if you know B's coordinate, and if you have to find centroid, indirectly you have to give a thought, array, it is centroid mentioned, it means this centroid is going to divide this AP in the ratio 2:1. So although it is not mentioned any ratio, we know that yes, centroid hai, to ye 2:1 mein divide karega. So you will know ratio is 2:1. You know the end point, that coordinates of A and P. So you using section formula also you can get the centroid. Okay, so that way, but in that case they will give figure and something. So for that you should know this also. Yes, centroid divides the median in the ratio 2:1. Okay, I'll repeat it. What I was telling here, suppose this figure is given, and now random values may not give you answer, but suppose I'm telling you, these two values are not given, and if I say here it is 5, 4, and the coordinates of P are given, let us say, 2, 1, and if the coordinates of centroid are asked in this figure, P and C are not given, the easiest, then if it is asked, then what we can do? So I'll take this 3, 1. Okay. कुछ problem नहीं है वैसे, but if you try absurd answer मिल सकता है. But just for explanation, I have given this 2 points. And if I ask what are the coordinates of this centroid, then you say 2 point centroid. We have studied that. Here, x1 plus x2 plus x3 upon 3. Right? Yes. Section formula. Yes. Section formula can be used because we know A's coordinate, we know P's coordinate, and we have to find G. But then there might be a question. कि sir, section formula use करने के लिए ratio तो दिया नहीं है. But then here your concept will come. Yes, then the concept centroid formula how you can use. That is what later on we'll discuss. But if this is given, you have to find an x2, x3 equations will be formed and that process it will become yes. So 2:1 ratio आपको पता है तो section formula use करके वहाँ पे खत्म कर सकते हो सब. Okay, so that's why you should know this. Okay. So I have done with my all formulas. So let's start discussing. Can you show one moment? See centroid. One second. It's not one second. It is somewhere. There is a confusion. Is centroid we are not getting by this section formula. If it is figure given over here and if it is mentioned in the example, G is the centroid. So it is already we know G is the centroid. And if coordinates of B and C are not given, only what are the given that they have mentioned, what the A is coordinate and P is a midpoint of BC. P is a midpoint of BC. Its coordinates are 3, 1. So A's coordinate and P's coordinates are given. And if G is a centroid, then find the coordinates of centroid in the figure. Suppose this they ask. Then what I said, section formula you cannot use because you, what is section formula? X1 plus X2 plus X3 upon 3. But for that you need to have X2 and you need to have X3, which is not there. So you can't get the value of X. But student, I said that, if AP, if we treat as a segment, then being a G centroid, we are 100% sure about the ratio in which this G is going to divide this AP. It will divide into the ratio 2:1. So we know M is to M. We know X1, Y1. We know X2, Y2. So if we know X1, Y1, if we know X2, Y2, if you draw the ratio, using section formula, you can get the value of x, mx2 plus nx1 upon n plus n. Is this clear? Is the doubt clear now what I talked about? Same way, y you can use y equal to my2 plus ny1 upon n plus n. Okay, any one of the formula that is, it means you can, one second. Say if values, there is a confusion, if all the three vertices are given, then we will be using X and Y, that centroid formula only. You don't have to use section formula unnecessary. Section formula where I have said, if supposed to confuse you, suppose a tricky way they ask the question, where it may happen, they will not give x2, y2, they will not give x3, y3, and yes, centroid divides. Remember, this is a property. Centroid divides. It is a property that centroid divides the medians in the ratio 2:1. It is a universal property. We know that. It is a truth. So we have to consider that as 2:1. Is this clear? So we will be using centroid formula only to find x and y. If x1, y1, x1, x2 and x3 is given, y1, y2 and y3 is given, we will be using this formula only. What I was trying to tell you, if x2, x3 is not given, instead of that midpoint is given, this P is given in the figure, and if centroid asks, so you should not be stuck. You have to think that, yes, I can use section formula over here and I can solve the example. So somewhere, something that way, if it is a, that's why I want.
एक्सप्लेन कि ऐसे हो सकता है, देयर इज नो चांस, 99.99% ऐसे कुछ नहीं पूछेंगे, बट वर्स टू वर्स प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑलवेज 0.01, वी शुड बी रेडी फॉर दैट. दैट्स व्हाई आई जस्ट क्लियर द कांसेप्ट. सो हाउ इट इज कैन बी आस्क्ड. ओके ठीक है, सो डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज. सेक्शन आपको सेंट्रॉइड ही यूज करना है. Okay, let's start solving some of the examples which are there. I have a list. I'll be making this PDF and I'll send it into the group. But meanwhile, we will discuss some of the examples. Okay, few examples that type of we have already done. So yes, I'll write that example. It will take little time. Segment AB. This type of question I was just talking. Maybe asked. It is might be there in schools MCQs also. You must have done school exams. Segment AB is parallel to y-axis, and coordinate of point A are 1, 3, then the coordinates of point B can be A 3, 1, B 5, 3, C 3, 0, and D 1, -3. Very good, very good. Option C, some of they have said. Option D, some of you have said. Very good. Yes. So option D is the correct option. Here there is a chance. C 3, Shubhrat, it cannot be 3, 0. I know where you have got mistake. Here, segment AB is parallel to y-axis. That's why today in Nano I have revised the concept of in 9th standard. Segment AB is parallel to y-axis. So if line is parallel to y-axis, if line is parallel to y-axis, this equation is always in the form of x equal to some constant. So segment AB is, if it is parallel to y-axis, so x will be equal to what? 1 will be the equation of that line. What does it mean? It means all the points on this line AB, their x coordinate is going to be 1. So if it is parallel to y-axis, x coordinate dekho. Simple, I'll make it. If it is parallel to y-axis, so y to uska opposite x, so x coordinate dekho, that is 1. So out of this whichever coordinate, which is having x as 1 coordinate, that will be your answer. So simple. Agar parallel to y-axis hai to, is this clear? Now, thoda sa change karta hu yahan pe, yahi question mein, thoda sa change, x-axis. सेगमेंट ए बी इज पैरेलल टू एक्स एक्सिस एंड कोऑर्डिनेट ऑफ द पॉइंट ए आर, पॉइंट मैंने वैसे ही रखे 1, 3, देन द कोऑर्डिनेट्स ऑफ द पॉइंट बी कैन बी, यस, नाउ इट विल बी, आंसर विल चेंज बी, बिकॉज इट इज पैरेलल टू एक्स एक्सिस, इट मीन्स वाई मस्ट बी इक्वल टू 3 ऑफ दैट एवरी पॉइंट ऑन दैट लाइन एंड लुक फॉर बी. सो वाई कोऑर्डिनेट 3 वाला पॉइंट आपका आंसर हो जाएगा. हैव यू अंडरस्टूड? This type of question may be asked to just know because their concept is being tested. Okay? Yeah. So what I'm repeating again, x-axis, so if it is parallel to x-axis, then look for the y-coordinate of the point through which line is passing. So y-coordinate, dekho. So y-coordinate 3 hai. So jiska y-coordinate out of 4 points mein se 3 hai, wahi point aapka answer hoga. Agar y-axis hoga, तो x कोऑर्डिनेट टू देखो वो व्हिच नो पॉइंट टू व्हिच इट इज पासिंग, x1 है तो जिसका 1 कोऑर्डिनेट है x कोऑर्डिनेट, दैट विल बी योर आंसर. सो अपोजिट वाला है, जस्ट थिंक इन दैट वे. ओके, नेक्स्ट वन,
Just clearing this is.
Just little bit not challenging as such. You can see here different type of examples will try.
A 4.8, B 5.5, C 2.4, and D 1.7 are the vertices of the parallelogram. Find the coordinates of the point of the intersection of its diagonals. Answers are, or you find first, let's see what your answer come, then I'll write the options. You do it and tell me what can be the answer. Achha, 3.6, that's the answer given. Very good. Quickly, that has to, this quickness has to be there for MCQ. 3.6. Correct. 2.6 answer has come. Just check it. Some mistake must be there. 3.6 is the correct answer. 3.6 is the correct answer. So diagonals. 3.6. So those who have not yet got diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. Instead of giving options, 3.6 directly, it's the correct option. See, student, it's a parallelogram, and in parallelogram, diagonals bisect each other. So it means if A, B, C, D, that if I name, and they have given 4.8, 5.5, then 2.4, and 1.7, so if diagonals are going to bisect, it means O becomes the midpoint. So O will become midpoint of AC. So orally you can say 4 plus 2, 6. 6 divided by 2, 3. And 8 plus 4, 12. 12 divided by 2, 6. That is 6. So 3.6 is the answer. Check from this side also. 5 plus 1, 6. 6 divided by 2, 3. 7 plus 5, 12. 12 divided by 2, 6. So 3.6 will be the answer. So this is, I can say that it is interesting one. You sidha nahi puchenge. थोड़ा ट्विस्ट करके ऐसा पूछ लिया वो मिड पॉइंट ही पूछना था बट पैरेललोग्राम के वाया पूछ लिया. ओके नेक्स्ट इज नाउ नेक्स्ट ऐसे अलग वाले तो नहीं बट डायरेक्टली बेस्ड ऑन दैट सेक्शन फॉर्मूला वी विल सी फ्यू एग्जांपल्स. अदर्स मिड पॉइंट फॉर्मूला वाले दे आर वेरी इजी दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू बी वेरी डिफिकल्ट एज सच. वन मोर एग्जांपल ऑफ दैट टाइप ऑफ वी नीड टू ट्राई. यस Yeah, this one I want. Baki straightforward wale I am not taking, but just simple pehle thode alag wale we will take. The line segment joining points -3, -4 and 1, -2 is divided by y axis in the ratio dash. Tell me the answer. The line segment joining points -3, -4 and 1, -2 is divided by y axis. Options I am not telling you, tell me the answer. Very good example. This type of example also can be asked in exam, which is based on 10th standard only and little tricky. Ratio it is asked. So 2:2, 3:1, 3:1, 3:1, correct, everyone, those who are giving, Kanishka, Suhani, correct, 3:1, correct, yes. So here the concept should be clear, what it is, 3:1, so those who have got answer, 3:1, how do they have got, so let us try to understand. So now the here you have x1 is -3, y1 is -3, x2 is 1 and y2 is -2. And they have not given anything else. We have to find n plus n, that ratio we have to find. Student, they have mentioned the line segment joining this point is divided by y axis. It is divided by y axis. It means the point which is dividing this line segment joining this two point. This point, this line, that y-axis is dividing. So it means that point must be lying on which axis? Y-axis pe hoga. See, I'll just tell you here. So here is the your y-axis. So suppose I have segment AB. Suppose this is my segment AB. Then this point which is dividing segment AB, they have said it is lying on y-axis. And we know that if the point is lying on y-axis, what can we say about its x-coordinate? X-coordinate kaise hoga uska? How much it will be? Zero. So we know it's jo point A or B ko, AB segment AB ko divide kar raha hai, uska x-coordinate already pata hai. So what is our formula? Our formula is to find x is mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n. But we know that point, point dot is lying on y-axis, because y-axis divide kar raha hai wo line segment ko. So x must be 0. So if x is going to be 0, student, 100% what will happen? This whole quantity which you are going to take on left hand side, 0 into anything will become 0. So 0 into m plus n becomes 0, and you will have m or x2 is 1. It's not right. X2 is 1 and n x1 is -3. Ye 0 ho gaya. M plus n ko left pe le lenge. X ki value 0 hai, to 0 into m plus n will become 0. So what you will have? 0 is equals to m into 1, it will be -3n. And then if you take -3n on left side, it will be pn is equals to m. So if you take n on right hand side, it will be 3 upon 1 is equals to m upon n. So ratio will be 3:1. Now, values, okay, okay. But if I would have asked the line segment joining points -3, -4 and -1, -2 is divided by x axis in the ratio. So x axis agar y axis ke jagah hota, so what coordinate you should have taken? 0. X axis pe hai. Then y will be equal to 0. So yahan pe x equal to mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n ke jagah ho jata, y equal to my2 plus ny1 upon m plus n. Remember, whenever you will have this, automatically this m plus n ye wala part 0 ho jata. So only you have to focus on this numerator.
And of course, if you solve, you will get again ratio n is to n. So these are the only two variations possible over here. That if it is y axis, we are going to take x equal to 0. If it is x axis, we will be taking y equal to 0, and we can get the, yes, we can, yes, 3 is to 1 again answer. Okay. If we, that is, even Ojas has tried that and he has got the answer. Is it going to be 3 is to 4, Ojas? If suppose same example, agar x axis pe hota, to y equal to 0 hoga, just try it. Right, ratio to same aana chahi actually, it should come same, but here I don't know, change hoga answer, yahan pe change hoga, y equal to 0 hoga na, so my2 plus ny1 upon n plus n, see this point, points, minus 4 and minus 2, sir, m plus n, where it is, m plus n, where it is, I didn't understand actually question, where m plus n has gone, that is the question or what, is do you want to ask whether m plus n, what happened to m plus n, is that the question? Yeah, yes, they just simply say, if I'm asking, simply say yes, you want to know what happened to m plus n. Okay, I'll explain. M plus n, I'll explain in detail now here, one second, and it is this part, I'll explain. I'll show that. I hope you have understood this, why x equal to 0 we have taken. Just tell me yes or no. Why x equal to 0 we have taken, that have you understood? Just say yes or no. That has asked the query. Why x equal to 0 we have taken? Yes. Okay. Okay, Kshitish. So now same formula. So I'll write again mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n. So x is 0 because the point is lying on y axis, which is dividing that line. So mx2 plus nx1. Now m plus n, it is a number. It is always a number. Ratio is a number. It cannot be negative. Ratio cannot be negative. So if I do this 0 and if I transfer all this quantity, it will become into m plus n equal to mx2 plus nx1. If I'll substitute say same time that value 1 and here this is minus 3. So see here, anything multiplied by 0 is always 0. So this is what next step we have got. 0 is equal to. So from here we have reached to this. I hope the doubt is clear. So remember, if it is divided by y axis, y equal to 0 aega, m plus n 0 hi ho jayega. Seedha, because whenever anything is multiplied by 0, value becomes 0. Is this clear? So that's why m plus n is vanished. Okay. Yeah, Kshitish, understood, I think. Now. Okay, let's move to the next part, next example. Can you show if x equal to 0? For this, can you show if x equal to 0? I didn't understand. One second. What, Tanishka? I don't know how to mute. One second. Oh, I didn't understand the x equal to 0. Why, do you mean to say y equal to 0? One second. Sir, can you show if x y equal to 0? Yes, it should be y equal to 0. So let us take one example. Let's see. I have that. We will take that. Same it is actually, same it is. Like that. One example we will take. That's what I was about to take. X equal to 0 wala. Yeah. Yes. I'll write that example. The ratio in which x-axis
divides the segment joining 3, 6 and 12, -3 is. Yeah, as you have asked, let's x-axis now. Try this. Yes, correct. 2:1. Correct. 2:1. Absolutely right. 2:1 will be the answer. I hope that now others also have understood this. It will be 2:1. So what it is? x1 is 3. y1 is 6. x2 is 12. y2 is equals to -3. So it will be y will be equal to 0. So y will be equal to my2 plus ny1 upon m plus n. And this y will become 0 because the ratio in which x-axis divides the segment. So x-axis, it means y will be equal to 0. So my2 is -3 plus ny1 is 6. And upon m plus n. So if you take m plus n on left hand side, it will become 0. So 0 is equals to -3m + 6n. So if you take -3m, it will be 3m = 6n. So m upon n, same time upon 6 upon 3. So 3 ones are 3 twos are. So m upon n is 2:1. Okay, so this way it will be 2:1. Next, one more example I'll take. Distance, let's see. Because there are few simple examples that I'm not discussing. We have done find distance from origin, find distance. So these are very straight away application based. Of course, there are chances with that type of it will be asked. But thoda different type ka le lete, which are not asked or yes. If the distance between point 2, 2, so I'll say that P 2, 2, point P, yeah, it is 2, 2 and Q 5, x is 5. Then x is equals to ? Options I'll give. There is a reason to give option. Yes. Do this and tell me what will be the value of x. Yes, very good, Avishkar. 6 will be the answer. Good. Others, let's see how many of you have got. Avishkar has given the answer. 6 is the answer. Anyone else has got answer? Answer is 6. So it will take time because we'll be using distance formula. So quickly you should be use that. 6 is the answer. We will get it. So this can happen, no? Like 1 minute, you may take more than 1 minute. So just see to it that in 1 minute, you should be able to solve at the max 1.5 minute. That is not a problem.
Okay, so you are able to give, but that speed has to be maintained. So yes, here distance formula. So they have given distance is equals to 5. So square root of directly you can take y2 minus y1. So 5 minus 2 the whole square plus x minus 2 the whole square. And if you simplify this, squaring on both sides, rather you can do, no need to, well, you'll be having this kind of things. Don't have that. Directly you can have square. Remove that square, square root sign. So it will be, so directly you can have 25 minus 5. So it will be 3 square plus x minus 2 the whole square. 3 square is 9. So 25 minus 9, it will be x minus 2 the whole square. And therefore 16 will be equal to x minus 2 the whole square. So instead of expanding here, I can just use my shortcut over here. I can take square root of 16. So square root of 16, it will become 4. So it will be x minus 2, taking square root on both sides. So minus 2 if I add, so 4 plus 2, I will be having x is equals to 6. Okay, so this is something like what I thought would be different or which can be asked. Also, midpoint, a very simple question can be asked again. I'll be sending this PDF, so no, and you can always look the watch this videos again on our channel. Now, very straightforward example we will take. The casting candidates are there. Yes, I am just writing this points minus 2 comma 0, b 0 comma 2, c 2 comma 3, b 2 comma 0. Out of, now read, I am not writing the question. You tell me out of these 4 points, which point lies to the right of the origin on x-axis? Out of these points, which point lies to the right of the origin on x-axis? Yes, right of, it is said, but read that, right of x-axis, and they have right of origin and on x-axis it is given. So read the question carefully. Answer is correct. Yes, Arya, D, Avishkar, you all have given answer correct. So read the question carefully. You will be able. So this way you have to see that P to the right of origin and on x-axis. So these are the two conditions given. It is not only on right of x-axis, but it is also on origin, on x-axis. So therefore, to the right of origin and on x-axis. Therefore, of course, the option will be 2 comma 0. That is D. Correct. So this way, some questions may be asked, which you have to read it carefully. You have to be very careful about it. Now, simply, just before leaving, one more example and then I'll wind up. Very simple example. It's very easy. Is 21. Sum of x coordinate is 21 and sum of y coordinate of a vertices of triangle, of course, student, is 15. You have to find x and you have to find y. Very easy. What will be the answer? Sum of x coordinate is 21 and sum of y coordinate is 15. Of course, centroid, it is entire. I should have mentioned that. What will be the coordinates of centroid? No, sum of the coordinates of centroid here. Centroid. Coordinates of centroid. Yes. That's why I didn't explain it properly, so you might have confused. Yes, it will be 7,5. 21 divided by 3, so sum. x1 plus x2 plus x3 is given. Therefore, directly value is given. So 21 should be divided by 3. So 7 and y will be 15 will be divided by 3, 5. I hope everyone has understood. So actually, students, sum when is they say it is they have given already x1 plus x2 plus x3. Ye value already diya hua hai. That is 21. So divide by 3. That will be the formula to find x. Okay. So this way, thoda twist karke same example they can ask. Now midpoint will be given and they can ask. So a 4 comma 7 and b 2 comma 1. And P 3 comma A is a midpoint of set AB. So find A, find A, A ko find karna hai, find A. 3 comma A is a midpoint of A comma midpoint of segment AB. Find A. A will be 4, correct? A will be 4. So just focus on Y coordinate. So 7 plus 1, 8 upon 2, answer will be 4. A will be equal to 4. Okay. Then for same way, they can ask examples on centroid. Centroid pe puch sakte hai, waise hai others. Ek last wala example leta hun, and then we will stop. This last one, and then I'll stop. Yes. Here is related to centroid only, student. Vertices of centroid are given 7 comma x, y comma minus 6. These are the vertices of centroid. Y comma minus 6, 9 comma 10. These are the vertices of a triangle. And centroid, its coordinates are given 6 comma 3. Find x and y. Find x and y. These are the three vertices of triangle, and 6 comma 3 are the coordinates of centroid. Find x comma y. Find it means they will give option, of course, to you. You have to select one of them. X is equals to 1 and y equal to 5. Just check it. Don't say 2. I want the value of x and y. So mention that x equal to what and y equal to what. X is 5 and y is 2. Correct. X is 5 and y is 2. Correct. Correct. X is 5 and y is 2. Correct. Is this clear? So they have purposely mentioned in the place of y, x. In the place of x, they have mentioned y. So don't write this. Yeah, and they will be giving options to you. Okay, so here value of x, that what you get, you have to mention. So it is 5 and y you will be getting 2. So that will be your answer. Okay. So yes, student, we have done with so this PDF, whatever there are some questions, they are very simple. Simple one I have not taken. So just these, those who are different, I have taken right now. So I'll be sending, I'll make a PDF of that. And I'll send it to you. Thank you very much. All the best. Take care. And bye-bye. Okay. All the best to everyone for CET. Bye. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.